if you want people to respect you, right. You understand? God said you can't walk around dressed like a harlot.
Bring it up.
Right? So there's a difference between how a harlot dress and how a princess dress. Right. That's what the Bible says. Read it again from the top.
Chapter 49, verse 6.
Come on.
And he said, it is a light thing.
God said it's a light thing, meaning what? It's easy. Come on.
That thou shouldest be my servant to raise up the tribe of Jacob.
That's what we doing. We come out here because we love our people.
Right.
We come out here to teach God's commandments. We come out here to teach you the things that we wish we were taught a long time ago. But it changed our whole course of life. You understand? Why? Because God said that we must do this to resurrect our people. We dead out here. We come out here to escape our reality. Most of our reality, we hate it. That's why we get high, that's why we smoke. We wanna leave, we oppress people. You understand? But God says that we must come out here to resurrect our people from this dead estate. Read on.
And to restore.
And to what?
Restore.
To restore something means that at one point in time, it was what? It was there. It was good. At one point in time, the 12 tribes of Israel, I'm talking about the black, Hispanic, and Native Americans,
right.
We was a royal priesthood.
Right.
But we fell away from that.
Right.
How did we fall away from that? Because we broke God's commandment. So we come out here, and it's a light thing for us to teach you again
teach
the
us.
First principle that God told us back in the wilderness, back during the time of Moses, back when we were a people.
To restore the preserve of Israel.
So we got to restore the preserve of who? Of Israel. Did God say restore all nations? He said Israel. Who are the Israelites today? But so the blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans scattered across the whole earth. That's who we be. You understand? Was that it on that?
Sir.
Read.
I will also give thee for a light to the Gentiles.
I will give thee to be what?
A light to the Gentiles.
What's the light do out here? What's that light do over there? It shines so you can what? So you can see. That's why we out here. You understand? Because this world is living in darkness. This is a dark world that we live in. We come out to the darkness to bring light to our people. The same way this street light shines so everybody can see, so you can not trip and fall in a pothole. You understand? That's the same way we come out here to teach you God's laws so that you can avoid all these traps out here. You know what God calls a trap in the Bible? A whore. That's a trap in this Bible. The Bible calls it a deep ditch. If you fall into a deep ditch, is it easy or hard to get out of? Huh? If you fall into a deep ditch, is it easy or is it hard to get out of? All right? God calls the black woman today, you understand, a deep ditch. You understand? Because most of them, all right, are not honorable. They're not modest anymore. You understand? Give me Proverbs chapter 7, verse 10.
Yes,
most of our women, all right, don't fit the description that we once had as a people,
that's
a
right.
royal people.
Right.
You understand? That's not the description that most of our women face today. Read what you got.
This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 7 and verse 10.
Come on.
And behold, there met him a woman.
You hear what the Bible says? The Bible said, behold, there met this man a woman. The Bible's going to describe this woman. What type of woman was this? Come on.
With the attire of an harlot.
The Bible said this woman had the attire of a harlot. What does that tell you? The Bible tells you that certain women dress a certain way. You understand? The Bible tells you that you can know a woman by the clothes that she wears. Did you hear what I just said? That just sent chills through your mind. Read it again from the top.
And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of an harlot.
Wait. I thought you couldn't judge a book by its cover. Didn't you hear that before? Guess what? That's not of the Bible.
That's right.
That's of the devil.
Right.
You understand? Because when you go to a job interview, are you going to walk in there with your pants sagged? No. Why? Because you want them to respect you.
Bring it on.
You want them to take you serious.
Bring it on.
So if you're trying to get a job, you're not going to walk in there with your pants sagged below your butt.
Right.
You understand? Because you want them to take you serious. It's the same thing with a woman and how she dressed.
That's
if you
right.
want people to respect you,
right.
you understand? God said you can't walk around dressed like a harlot.
Bring it on.
Right? So there's a difference between how a harlot dress and how a princess dress.
Right.
That's what the Bible says. Read it again from the top.
This is the book of Proverbs chapter 7 verse 10. And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of an harlot.
Now listen to how this Bible describes the woman dressed like a harlot. Come on.
And subtle of heart.
It says she's subtle of heart. You know what that means? Say it again. Come close. You know what that means? It says she is subtle of heart. Our women today, are women subtle? Are they sneaky? Are women manipulative?
No.
You understand? Are women conniving today?
Not all of them.
Not all. I'm not this righteous woman right here, right? But I'm talking about the rest of these women out here, right? Are women out here, are they subtle of heart? All right, subtle means that she may say one thing, but she really thinking something else. A woman today, do they deal like that a little bit? Right? I know not this righteous woman right here, right? But it's some woman today, right? Woman, your wife might, this your wife?
Yeah.
All right, so she might say, hey, babe, look, you know, it's kind of warm inside the house. You know, it's kind of warm inside the house today. You know, what's that supposed to mean? Huh? Yeah, you see what I'm saying? She wants some hell! Right? But did she say that? She wants you to turn the air on? Is it so our women today, not this righteous one right here, right? But our women
Bring
today,
it out.
Do they be subtle of heart a little bit?
Yeah.
A little bit, they be subtle of heart. Alright? Right? Now it's some sisters that's more now that's love right there. You understand? That's less discretion.
Yeah.
Right? But what I'm trying to show you is that a woman can be subtle, even the righteous ones. That's what I'm trying to show you.
Yeah.
Now, with some sisters that take that same subtlety, is what the Bible calls it, and they use it for evil.
Right.
You know what I'm talking about?
Right.
All right, read it again from the top.
And behold, there met him a woman with the attire of a harlot.
So there met him a woman with the attire of a harlot. Come on.
And subtle of heart.
And she was subtle of heart. Come on.
She is low.
She's what?
She is low.
So some of these sisters out here that me manipulating these men, right?
Right.
She's what?
Is low.
So a lot of the sisters, right, that you meet, they got their breasts all out. They got their butt all out, right? Are they usually meek and quiet and gentle?
Bring it on.
Or are they what? They are
low.
What? Are they what?
They
usually got a big black mouth. Which one is? Which one is?
Bring it on.
Just my sister right here. Which one is? Right, the ones that show the most. Right, they usually got the biggest mouth. Right, now is the Bible the true book? Yes, indeed it is.
Right.
Because this Bible is talking about the so-called black man. This Bible is talking about the Hispanic man. This Bible is talking about the Native Americans scattered across the whole earth. That's what this Bible is written
Bring it
for.
On.
Right. Because you don't see, guess what? Have you ever heard of a big mouth Chinese woman? No.
Teacher.
Have you ever heard of a big mouth white woman?
Bring it
Have
up.
You ever heard of that?
Bring it up.
Does it exist? Does it exist on the earth?
Yeah.
Right, but it's not, that's not the stereotype
right.
of that people.
Right.
But somehow it has become the stereotype of my beautiful sisters. Because we've fallen so far away from this Bible.
Right.
Come on.
Stubborn!
And what?
And stubborn!
The sisters, they got their breasts all out like that. They got their butt all out like that. Do they be stubborn?
Bring
do they want to do it your way? Do they want to submit to a man? Or do they want to choose whatever man they want for the night? Which one is it? Huh? That means she's what? Stubborn. Because she cannot submit herself to one man.
That's
right. Sister right here, are you submitted to one man? Yes, it's many sisters out here that have not taken that step to build their nation up. They haven't taken that step. That's a righteous example that you're setting for all of these young women out here. We need more righteous examples just like that.
Her feet abide not in her house.
You know why? You know why her feet don't abide in her house? Why do the women that got her breasts out, her booty out, she loud, she obnoxious, she stubborn, you understand? Why don't she abide in her house? Why don't you think she abide in her house? She wanna be the boss, right? What is she doing out? If she's not in her house, where is she? She's what? She's what? She's in the streets. You know what that means? She belongs to the street. You heard that before?
Yeah.
That was written first here.
That's right.
That was written first. That came from the Bible. Wait, but there's people out here now talking about, yeah, she belongs to the street. She belongs. Oh, I like that. I'm going to start using that too. But guess where they got it from? Right here in the Bible.
Oh,
the Bible say every sister that dress like that. You understand? Belongs where? The ones that dress like that and act like that belong where? To the streets. That's where they belong. They don't belong with a righteous man that fears God and keeps his commandments, because that woman will be a headache for him.
Bring it up.
You know what the Bible says you should do if you get a woman like that? You know what the Bible says you can do? Give me a click. Hold that. We're going to come back. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, all right? You know what the Bible says we should do if you get a woman like that? You know what the Bible says you should do?
We're going to read it for you, all right?
The wisest man on earth. Y'all know what his name was? What was it? King. It was Jesus, all right? In other words, King Solomon, all right? Because Solomon came back on the earth as Christ, all right? He was regenerated to come back on the earth. But listen to what he said when he was Solomon walking on this earth. You got what I want?
7.
Verse 26.
This is
that
this,
it? Yes. Read what you got.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes.
Chapter 7. Verse 26.
Verse 26.
Come on.
And I find more bitter than death.
He said, this is worse than death. I would rather die, you understand, than to go through this. Come on.
The woman whose heart is snares and nets.
That's that subtlety that we spoke about, right? Her, she's subtle, you understand? Because her heart, meaning her mind, is what? Snares and nets. Y'all know women like that? They woman, they heart is snares and nets. How they can trap a man, you understand? Come on.
And her hands.
Child support, you know what I'm talking about. Huh? You know what I'm talking about, come on.
And her hands as bands.
Her hands is what?
Bands.
As bands, you understand? Come on.
Whoso pleaseth God.
If you please God, if you a righteous man and you fear God, God says you're gonna do this, come on.
Shall escape.
He shall what?
Escape.
He shall what?
Escape.
What that mean? It's time to go. You understand, it's time to go. You understand? That's why women today, they can't keep a man.
Right.
Our sisters today can't keep a man.
Right.
You understand? They can't keep a man. Why? Because her heart is snares and nets.
Right.
We got to come out of that lifestyle. You understand? Before you leave, I got to get this for you. Titus chapter 2. All right? Titus chapter 2. This is what you're supposed to be doing. All right? This is what you're supposed to be doing. And as a man, all right, this is what you're supposed to be doing. All right? Titus chapter 2, start at verse 1.
Yes, sir.
Come on. This is Titus.
This is the book of Titus chapter 2, verse 1.
Come on.
But speak thou the things which become sound doctrine.
Speak the things that become sound doctrine. What we're teaching today, that's sound doctrine.
That's right.
We're teaching you the Bible, precept upon precept, line upon line. I don't close the book and say, let me talk to you, give you a sermon. Let me tell you how I feel today. When you go to church, do you go to church?
Yeah.
Do you go to church? When you go to church, is that what happens? You sit down in the pew, the pastor reads one scripture, he closes the book, and he talks to you. Ain't that what happened in your church? What happened in your church? He read precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little, there a little. Say it again. He explains some things. Okay, very good. All praise. We need to have a sit down with your pastor, because maybe we teach the same thing. Maybe we can come out here and build this community up together. How about that? All right, come on.
That the aged men be sober.
Be sober. What's the name of your church? New Beginnings Outreach. What's the pastor? Pastor Sherman Watkins. We're going to contact Pastor Sherman Watkins. See if we can have a sit down. See if we can build together. All right, because it's a lot of brothers and sisters that need to be out here married just like y'all.
Right.
All right, come on.
Grave, temperate, sound in faith.
This is how the men should be. They should be grave, temperate, sound in faith. All right, now, when we think about faith, when we're talking about faith, you know what faith goes into? Because faith without is dead. What is it? Works, right? Now those works, according to the Bible, is what? It's God's commandments.
That's right.
That's what those works are. You understand? So faith without is dead, right? Let's read about some of these works. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 22.
Yes, sir.
I'm going to read verse 5 for you. All right? No, give me Leviticus chapter 19.
Yes, sir.
All right?
Verse 27, is that what I want? Verse 21 to 5, either one of those.
Because we're talking about faith, and that's what you need to build your people up. Faith, if you don't have faith, right? Really, you don't have a vision. And without a vision, you don't know which way to go. All right? So we're trying to show you the way. It's right here. Come on.
This is the book of Leviticus, chapter 21 and verse 5.
Come on.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
What that mean? What that mean? Read it again.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
What that mean? They say you can't make baldness upon your head. What that mean? What that mean? Read it again from the top.
They shall not make baldness upon their head.
You can't make baldness upon your head. How do I make baldness upon my head? I got hair on my head. How would I make baldness upon it? By cutting it. How would I cut it? If I want it to be bald. Would I use some clippers, put a guard on it, cut it down? Is that how we make it bald? I would make it bald that way? I would use what? A razor. That's gonna make it what? That's gonna make it clean. You understand? That's gonna make it bald. Right? This ain't talking about don't put no clippers on, shave it down. You understand? It say don't make baldness specifically. Right? Come on.
Neither.
So on top of your head, you can't shave the bald, right? God said you can't do that. Come on.
Shall they shave off the corners of their beard?
Neither shall you do what to your beard? You can't shave your beard off. This is a law for who? The woman? This for the man. You understand? So when we read this Bible, guess what? We have laws that pertain to the, and we got laws that pertain to the, very good. All right. So when you go through these scriptures, you got to find out which scriptures pertain to who? Pertain to you, pertain to you. That's how you have to read this Bible. All right, so you can't continue to do what? To shave off your beard. You can't continue to do that. Why? Because God said that you can't do that. You know, we read the Bible dictionary. You know what it says about this beard? You know what it says about your beard? It says that that's a badge of manly dignity.
Bring it
that,
out.
That is. To distinguish the man from the woman. God didn't give that to the woman.
That's right.
He gave it to the man. And he said, this is your badge of honor right here.
Right.
You know what we do? You know what we do? We shave it off. Most of us have learned that because the society that we live in, guess what? The society that we live in, these people weren't given God's law. So they're not held to the standard. But we are, but we're in captivity. So we have conformed ourselves to be just like them in order so we can provide for our family. But we gotta get away from that because this is how we're gonna provide for our family.
Bring it out.
Coming back to keeping God's laws. That's how we're gonna provide for our family.
Right.
So you can't continue to do what? Shave your beard off. That's the badge of manly
dignity
that the Lord gave you. You gotta keep that on your face. You understand? That's a noble thing. All right, that's a law for who?
Right.
A man.
That's
you understand?
Right.
Now, God also gave laws for the woman, right? Go read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 22. Read what you got.
This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 22 and verse 5.
Come on.
The woman shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
So this is talking about the woman. The woman can't wear that which pertains to who? A man. You understand? What does that look like today? What type of clothes do women wear today that pertains to men? He said the baggy jeans, right? What if the jeans won't baggy? Do they still pertain to men? She says, yeah, she's right. You understand? She knows that. Her grandmother never wore pants.
That's right.
Am I right or am I wrong? She's right. I'm right. You understand? Her grandmother never wore pants. Right? Why? Because of this law right here. But you know what happened? We fell away. We fell away from who God called us to be. And we cleave. We cleave to this.
That's right.
This is why we have become Gentiles here. We've come here to bring the light to you. See the light? It's shining in the darkness. We got to bring that to our people because we're living in darkness right now.
Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family.